away from the GOP.
Maybe too late. Radio is the least of it. Look at the pickle that Limbaugh's gaffe put Romney and Santorum in. These guys are supposed to be Ward Cleaver and the approachable Ken doll of politics. They're ducking the cameras for a couple of days, and when they finally get asked about Rush Limbaugh, all they can say is hada, 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 and that it was a poor choice of words, like he should have insulted her more politely. The collateral damage goes to the GOP, and I think this gender gap, which was pre-existing, is wider and deeper as a result of what Rush has done.
And it's not just syndicated talkers on the right. Here's Bill Handel, very popular guy in Los Angeles, talking about the Kansas abortion law.
The doctor has to show these dumb-ass women that what they're
you
going
just
to...
stepped into it once again. Let me tell you something.
What do you mean I just stepped into it?
Whatever you just said is going to be taken so completely out of context.
I mean, out of context?
How do you take that out of context, Eric Bollert?
It is what it is. It's misogyny, it's sexism, it's rampant all over talk radio. You talked about who's going to carry these shows. We've been monitoring WABC, Rush Limbaugh's flagship station in New York. They have aired over the last Thursday, Friday, Saturday, 200 unpaid ads during his program.
Public service announcements.
They are losing money every day they put Rush Limbaugh on the radio, period.
Well, the Heart Association said they didn't even want their
right?
PSAs.
They've got charities that don't even want to be
they
on his show.
They can't give it away.
Holland, that's got to be a first, to have the American Heart Association say, we don't want to be in your program. We won't take the freebie. What about that?